My name is Claire Wilcott, and I was born May 13, 1910, in Ogden, Utah. I was 8 years old when my father died of the flu in 1918, and I remember that as if it were yesterday. It was a traumatic experience, really, and my mother had five children. The youngest one was just a baby, I mean, born in August, and this was in October, I think. So then trying to decide what to do and all of that, but then all of us moving to California when I was 9 years old. We came, first of all, we moved to Long Beach where my mother had a sister. The sister arranged for a living place for us and so forth. And she went to business school and learned how to type and take shorthand. And the first job she got was to be working for a land development company in Lake Elsinore. And so we moved there. And I went from, I think, fifth grade through high school at Lake Elsinore. I don't ever remember feeling that we were poor. She had a little bit of money left from selling a home and that sort of thing. And my father was wonderful in that when we were each of us born, he took out a life insurance policy that would mature at when we were 18. And if he passed away, no more premiums need to be made. So when we turned 18, we had that little bit. Wouldn't amount to much now, but it did then. So all of us, all five of us, went on to school. I left Elsinore Union High School and went to UCLA. I wanted to be a home economics teacher because I loved the one I had in high school. And thought that would be a, and in those days you only had to have 3 years. And UCLA was at Vermont Avenue, not at Westwood then, for 1 year. And then we transferred to Westwood in 1929. I graduated in 28 and was 1 year there and then got my degree, but I couldn't get a job. When I got my teaching credential from UCLA, I did have friends who were able to go to law school. That was way back when, which was quite unusual. And I remember one friend went to medical school, but mostly the options were become a secretary, a nurse, or a teacher. Those were, most everybody had those options, but that was all.
Pass. All right, one at a time, please. Jack, Judy, now let's see if we can't get to the bottom of this.
Well, then I couldn't get a job, so that's why I came to Pasadena. Because I looked around and my mother was ill at the time and at White Memorial Hospital, and they needed nurses. This was during the Depression, like now. So I looked around, and the only school that would give me credit for the science and all I had taken at UCLA to become a home ec teacher, they did at Pasadena Hospital, but none of the others. Good Samaritan, White Memorial, none of them would do that. And they had this program with Occidental College, and they had five or six young women from Oxy that they put me with so that we didn't have to take those extra courses, and we all finished about not quite a year before the rest of them. When I first came here in the 30s, I couldn't believe it. I mean, I'm serious about this. I couldn't believe it. The Pasadena Hospital would not allow black people. And I remember finally a wonderful guy, he was a minister in one of the black churches here, was the first person they ever allowed to come to the Pasadena Hospital. And we all liked him. I mean, he was just a wonderful guy and gave him extra care and so forth. I was a student then. When I got my public health certificate and started working for the Visiting Nurse Association, I really used a lot of gas because I drove all over Pasadena. And I thought, well, it'd be nice not to just have money to pay at the gas station, I should get a credit card. I couldn't because I was a single woman. Bullock's finally opened. I thought that was before my second marriage. I thought it'd be nice to have a credit card there. I couldn't get a credit card there either because I'm a single woman. Many things happened that were very uncomfortable and unfortunate for me because I was a single mother. Some women wouldn't let their children play with mine because I was a single mother. And I wanted my son to become a Cub Scout. This was at Hamilton School, and the Cub Scout man came to see me and he said, "We only take boys who have a father to help us with our program." And I said, "Well, of all the people, my little kid needs that experience." You know, those kind of discrimination things happened because I was a single mother.
I wish every boy in America could be a scout. And I'm convinced that every scout who takes his rank requirements and his merit badges seriously will find, as I have, that such preparedness is the key to many doors.
So I worked, went to school, and raised two children during that period of time. And then I went to work for the school system then, got my health and development credential, which is a teaching credential, which you had to have then. I don't think you do anymore, and to be a school nurse, but you did then. And went to work for the schools in 1945, the year the war ended. Well, some people had more than one school. I did for a while. I had Burbank and Noyes. But you had limited to 1,000 students, and Longfellow did have that many. And bless his heart, Ralph Hornbeck knew me and wanted me to take over for a girl that was retiring. I loved every minute of it there. I loved the people, the parents, the faculty, and my job. In 1945, at the end of the war, my sister called me and said, "A friend of ours has come up and we're going to go out for dinner. I think you've met him," she said, but I hadn't, "and we would like to have you join us." So he picked me up. That's when we were living down near Hamilton School. So we went to dinner and I liked him quite well, and he seemed to like me. That was on Saturday night. He said, "Could I see you tomorrow?" And I said, "No, we're going to church. And then in the afternoon, my mother gave me a lot of peaches, and I'm going to can peaches." So he showed up about 12 o'clock and helped me can peaches. And he told my sister 2 days after that experience that he knew he wanted to marry me and have the rest of his life with me because of the way I handled my children. 2 years later, we got married. Well, for a long time, I really missed the trolley car that went all the way up. I used to use that before I had a car. And buses weren't available like they are now. I missed that. And I just love the old houses. I still do. I like to drive down in the southern part below Del Mar and see all those beautiful houses that were where Bullock's and Macy's now are now. They were beautiful houses like that. And around City College, there were beautiful homes, still are. There's still a lot of those craftsman houses around that area. Going out to, on the trolley car, to LaManda Park. Do you remember LaManda Park? And I miss the stores like Nash's and Hertel's and that wonderful grocery store, Marvel Grocery. I forgot to, we didn't have refrigerators, you know, electric refrigerators. We had an ice man that came twice a week and had a thing underneath that collected the drops that I used to water plants with. And we got really well acquainted with the ice man. I kind of miss that too.